Hey everyone, this is Rachel Kosha and you are watching Science and the Environment on the Rafi Report. Remember when the Rubik's Cube first came out? I still don't know why it seems so cool, but just like many of you, I rushed to the store to get one. After hours of no success, I finally gave up. Little did I know, the solution lies within science. Recently, an international team of researchers discovered every possible solution to the Rubik's Cube. Their results found that every possible combination can be solved in 20 moves or less. The solution lies within algorithms, which is a mathematical term meaning sequence of steps. By using a sequence called God's algorithm, the team has ended the 30-year search for the most efficient way to solve the Rubik's Cube. This whole study was completed using computers provided by Google and took only a few weeks. This new information will also require less time needed for the puzzle to be solved. As of right now, the record time to beat is 7.08 seconds. If you think your skills come close, please feel free to leave a video on my Facebook page. In other news, NASA has been working on a computer study to determine how a small nuclear explosion in one part of the world would affect a global climate environment. The results are bleak. The study shows that if 100 Hiroshima-sized bombs, each as powerful as 15,000 tons of TNT, were released during war between two developing world nuclear powers, the resulting fires would release 5 million metric tons of black carbon into the lowest layer of our atmosphere. Once there, the soot would absorb heat from the sun and begin to rise, becoming trapped in our atmosphere. The carbon would simulate a shield, causing Earth to cool, resulting in a drastic climate change. This reverse global warming may sound good, but in reality, would be devastating. Countless plants and animal species would quickly die off due to the drastic temperature change and decrease in rainfall. The ozone layer would also thin, which would result in an increased exposure to ultraviolet rays. This would lead to a whole new range of health issues, most life-threatening. While the possibility of this occurring may seem unrealistic at first, consider the fact that 100 Hiroshima-sized bombs only make up 0.03% of the entire world's nuclear weapons arsenal. The environment is fragile, and we must do our very best to keep it stable. Now it's time for the unique species of the week. This week, I'd like to introduce this adorable primate called the slender loris. This nocturnal species is most commonly found in the tropical rainforest of southern India. These guys are only 7 to 10 inches long and do not have a tail. An interesting fact about the slender loris is that they are normally found in pairs or small groups. In fact, they become violent if removed from these groups within a setting such as a zoo. They also enjoy eating fruits, leaves, insects, bird eggs, and even lizards. Thanks for watching Science and the Environment on the Rafi Report. I'm Rachel Kosha, and I will see you all next week. Thank you.